Good morning. You listen to FloorDaily.net, and I'm Kemp Haar. I'm at the BDNY show on a Sunday, and I'm with Paul Clary, the president of Tarkett Hospitality. Paul, how you doing?
I'm doing great, Kemp. Always good to see you in New York.
Yeah, it's good to be with you. This is one of my favorite shows because it's got so much eye candy here. This one really does focus on the design element. Yeah. It's in the right place here in New York because you can get here. There's three airports servicing it, but the brands are here, the procurement people are here, the designers are here, and it's not a huge show, so it doesn't take all day to walk around, right?
Yeah, it's a very manageable show, and to your point, it's really focused on design. It's really focused on the custom aspects, and so all the designers want to be here. A lot of the local designers give up their Sunday and come into the show, and we have people coming up from D.C. on the train, so it really caters well to our industry every year.
A little background on you. Obviously, you were at Mohawk for many years, I think 15 or so years.
Yes.
Then you left there, went to Lexmark, and then Tarkett bought Lexmark. And actually, at this show this year for the first time, you're in one space, right?
That's correct. We did it at HD. It was very successful, and we're here now, again, just featuring all custom products. Great reaction. The Tarkett story makes sense. As you and I have talked about in the past, we see our industry going to this multi-surface areas in rooms and corridors and public spaces. And ourselves at Tarkett, we feel we've got a great offering to work with that group and that design community.
Let's get to the surface types in a minute. Let me first ask you just about the business. What we hear, and by the way, we hear different things, but ever since this last recession, after the recovery, this hospitality business has been on fire. And it's been mostly on the new construction side, but also now there's been more renovation. But we did get a little glimmer for our November issue, we've got our hospitality report, that we might actually be at the peak. And while the flooring business, which is the last thing to go in, hadn't felt it yet, there might be a little bit of a dip next year in what's being spent in this category, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, I think for new construction, that's absolutely right. My feeling is that very soon we're going to see the occupancy rate slow, which actually favors renovation. We have not seen a lot of renovation in the last 2 or 3 years because a hotel gives up revenue when they shut down to renovate. And with record occupancy and record revenue, nobody's shutting down. So we actually think there could be some upside to that on the renovation side.
Well, let me tell you, because I have two kids that are millennials, what's happened to this business. I'm going to tell you, they don't want to own anything. They want life's experiences. They're out there spending a disproportionate amount of their budget traveling, and it's been a boon for this business, right?
It's absolutely right, and the brands, the franchise is doing a great job developing specific brands to cater to your children and my children. I mean, Moxie is a great example of that. Hilton are doing things with Signia and Canopy, and it is a huge part of the market, and they have got discretionary money. They will spend on room rates more than you and I would be willing to spend on room rates.
I think it's interesting you threw out that Moxie brand name because you and I are in flooring business, and I think they put warehouse floors in those Moxies, don't they?
In the public spaces, there's some polished concrete, but they've got a lot of LVT. Some of them are using area rugs as well. I mean the franchises are doing a good job giving their owners options, but LVT has grown exponentially in the last 4 years.
You know, this business is a science, and they've got this FF&E budget that they've got to live within. And, you know, what they always talk about is how much they can spend per unit, meaning per room. So you and I both know that they've recently been switching from carpet over to LVT, even in the upscale properties. Well, we just recently heard about in Arizona, the 500-room Hilton in downtown Phoenix is all LVT now. So, but, you know, that costs more than putting in carpet. And so as they look at that FF&E budget, where are they taking away from to be able to invest in this more expensive hard surface flooring?
That's a great question. I think they're having to balance in their average room rates. There's obviously some savings on electronics. We're seeing hotels now not use some case goods. So instead of a closet, you now just have a hook on the wall. And so there's different things they're doing. I do think we'll continue to see them try and balance what they think is right for their ultimate user, which are people like you and I who travel a lot, and then people who are doing leisure travel.
So let's talk about these brand standards. Each one of these big brands, they have brand standards. Tell us what's going on, the flooring trends with these brand standards, if you will.
Like we said earlier, we're seeing much more multiple surfaces. So we're down, but we're also seeing a lot of high design. So one of the things we think will happen is we'll see more area rugs going in on top of LVT. To your point, that increased average cost, so yep, there has to be some balancing there. But overall, we're seeing maybe room sizes come down a little bit, and that's part of how they offset the cost. And we're also just seeing a lot more of the franchises wanting to give the owners a local flavor. So I know you're very familiar with the Edwin in Chattanooga. That's a great example of how you can have a brand standard but allow the local owner to reflect what's going on in his or her community. And we're seeing that even in select service. We're starting to see a lot of the franchises give the owners more freedom to do those kind of things. Obviously, the compromise is going to be on the cost per unit, and they've got to balance that from an FF&E and from an operating side as well.
You bring up the Edwin, I got to mention, that was a year late getting finished and it went over budget, but it is a really nice property.
It's stunning. It was Getty's did the work on it. It's won tons of awards, and it's a great place to host people.
It's actually the cover of my November issue. So
Very timely. Yeah, it's a beautiful, beautiful hotel.
All right, so let's talk about what your message is here. You've got this space. I know you're talking about some particular products. As you mentioned before, this is a custom business.
Yeah.
So what's the Tarkett message here?
I mean, our message is our only job is to allow the designers to execute on their design vision. In terms of all the surfaces they're now using, we feel we're the only global company that can provide that for them. So we can do Axe Minister, which is obviously 100% custom. We can do any tufted broadloom custom. We can do Carpetal custom, LVT, Rigid. We can all of those things to help them realize their goal. And then we also got all the accessories, you know, the wall base, a bunch of different accessories that will truly allow a designer to come up with a custom vision. We'll help them with budget. We'll help them get to where they want to get to. So again, it's about just saying this is a custom industry and Tarkett provides custom solutions.
You know, I got to tell you, I'm glad they've got name tags here because about every third one says Patel on it. I don't know how we keep them apart. I mean, I'm going to tell you, I just learned today that the Asian Patel family could own almost half the properties in this country.
Yep. I think the last statistic I saw, which was at the American Asian Hotel Owners Association meeting, was 48%. Oh. It's a great American story. These people were immigrants. They've come in. They've bought hotels, they employ people locally. You understand the hospitality business, and they're a powerful group.
One last question about this category, lodging category. Yeah. What's Airbnb doing to this lodging category?
I think we're seeing them have an impact, but I also think that the major franchises have figured out that they're basically online booking agencies as well. So you've seen Marriott and Hilton and Choice and IHG all beef up their online presence. And so I think Airbnb is making everybody else better at providing that online service. There's always going to be a segment of the community, like our children, who will always want to go to Airbnb first. But it's changing the industry.
Yeah, I do know that it's affecting that limited service piece of the business.
Yeah.
It's taking some market share, and they're concerned about it.
Yeah,
Paul, it's great to talk to you again. Been talking to Paul Clary, the president of Tarkett Hospitality at the BDNY Show, and you've been listening to Kempar and FloridaAlley.net.